Going out with a streak of Tippex across your nose isn't everybody's idea of style, but it certainly worked for the frontman of this group at number two.
Marvellous!
How do I look?
You look fantastic now!
Do I look like...
Who?
Oh!
In the late 70s, a bloke called Stuart Goddard became adamant and formed a punk group. He asked Malcolm McLaren to advise the band, which he did, advising all of them bar Adam to leave and form Bow Wow Wow. Nice one, Malcolm.
There was a few people in Adam and the Ants in the late 70s, and Malcolm, as far as I know, he got in with them and he got the Ants and they all blew out Adam. And I remember somebody telling me Adam was standing there crying one day. They all gave him the sack, which was nasty.
If I hadn't have gone through that experience, I wouldn't have really started working with Marco, and things are supposed to be as they're supposed to be. But it was quite upsetting because it really left, or I just said, you know, I want the name.
And he told me the whole McLaren thing, how he'd got McLaren in to kind of revamp the band, paid him a grand for McLaren's ideas, and McLaren came up with this kind of Burundi, Apache, wild Indian thing. Yeah, I mean, they were good ideas, but they were formless, you know, so how do you do it? You know.
I think we were lucky to have Chris, our drummer, working in on it, because I think he was even more involved.
He just had two separate roles, and when he was in the studio, he was the producer. I mean, I didn't have any problem with that.
You could tell it was going to go places just from Adam's attitude. You know, this band are going to be huge. You know, we're going to be household names within 6 months. And we were. And he was absolutely adamant.
By that time, we were kind of ready to just compete. We were just ready to compete, and we did. Calling our music a game was more provocative. It was kind of, a lot of people really hated the idea of that arrogance, but that was it, you know.
He had a definite vision of what visually what it all should look like, down to the last detail. So there was no point in trying to interject, oh, I don't know about that and I don't know about this, because the geezer's been thinking about it for months and it's all he thinks about.
The way the music worked was essentially the three of us. The way the look worked was essentially Adam.
The line across the nose was a declaration of war, really, on a music business. Just, you know, this is it, you know. This is the band that everyone loves to hate.
Ant mania had swept the nation, but within the band there were still intense philosophical problems.
You know, there would be, like, sort of discussions at the back of the bus saying, look, lads, we are the biggest band in England. Now, there's certain problems, you know, with this, with how it's going. Namely, we're not getting shagged. Now, we should know, why are we not getting shagged?
It was really just a combination of quite heroic characters, really. The flamboyance of piracy and highwaymen, you know, the fact that men could be quite foppish and it's quite scary at the same time.
When it went number one, it was just like, yes, yeah, this will do, this is great. The pressure aspect didn't hit till later.
The band had been having a lot of internal sort of disputes and struggles, and it was really all about... It's all about money.
The spirit of the band wasn't there anymore. We had three managers, you know, and it was having to book an appointment to do a sound check sort of thing, and it just wasn't... I think we were just exhausted.
So it was see you later. and for Adam a solo career, although Marco stayed on and Chris Hughes kept producing.
At the time it seemed logical. You know, I think his time with that band of people, it was, you know, it'd come to an end.
If you're not getting on as well as you should get on, then you just can't carry it off. It doesn't sound right, doesn't look right.
Goody Two Shoes was Adam's first solo thing, and we did it with Chris. Lyrically, it was the, you know, because Adam's big thing in interviews at that time was, I don't drink and I don't smoke. And people was always taking a pop at him at that.
Don't drink, don't smoke, what do you do? Don't drink, don't smoke, what do you do? Subtle innuendos follow, must be something inside.
That was Adam's last number one, and after a brief comeback in 1990, he's been concentrating on an acting career, whilst the Soldier Ants continue to write, record and produce.
I wanted people to have that feeling of running in on Friday morning to school and saying, God, did you see that band? What was that all about? Was it any good? And I wanted people to say, no, they were crap, they looked like puffs. No, they were brilliant.
I think it had to look as good as it sounded. You know, it was, you know, here we are and lock up your daughters sort of thing.
Must be something inside.